Don't be afraid to be comfortable. And comfortability comes through discovery, it comes through learning, and it comes through experiencing things. Not everything is gonna feel good, but if you're approaching something with good intention, as Kris just said, then you learning, and you know, through those experiences is what ultimately is going to contribute to better outcomes. The better outcomes that we want to see are science and research that looks different, that's including everyone.
I would say be transparent and be uncomfortable with being uncomfortable during those difficult conversations. You're not in danger. It's just uncomfortable. And so, and the transparent part is making sure that everybody understands the expectations, right? As you move forward through your research, if that's what you're doing as partners. You have difficult conversations. Maybe you're uncomfortable, but do it in kindness. Because that's important in work situations. It's important in collaborative situations, and it's important in team science.
Yeah, but more than that, I mean, we're people, and kindness feels good to people. Mm-hmm. So be kind to people.
Yeah.
And each other.
So that's a great question. What will the basic researcher, and why do they need community members involved? Well, community members don't have to be exactly the same thing every time, right? So maybe their community members are physicians that are working in the community. They're the next person who's going to be talking to their patients about this medicine that they're working on or this intervention. So that is the community, right? It's the clinician that knows the people who are gonna take the medicine and needs to inform the basic researcher. So community members around the table just means someone outside of the realm of what people are, you know, the lab scientist is doing. It's maybe the next row out, or it's someone that has a different expertise. Many times it's who I go to church with, who's walking down the street, who's shopping at Food Lion, but it's also the people that are just in a different job than you are, right? That can impact you.
I agree. I agree. And I think that more than anything, we're all part of a plan, some sort of master plan, right? And so even from the person who's the most basic of researcher, who doesn't think that their work, their name, that they're putting on anything is gonna go that far, or they're not, you know, or the data that they're contributing as part of a small subset is nowhere near, you know, going to be as grand as something that actually, you know, is more telling about a population. But everybody's a small part of the puzzle, a small part of the plan. And so, again, leaning on those things like respect, accountability, integrity, intention, you know, and understanding that you are part of something larger. And when you are affecting people, when your research, when your data is affecting people, those people are heartbeats. And so you should just always remember that you are connected to something, and what you're producing will go on to affect something else. And the inroad of that will be a person or people. And so, you know, just always know that you're a part of that master plan and that you're contributing to making people better. So even as, you know, a basic researcher who's under a lot of paper, under a lot of microscopes, not being seen, thinks they have zero visibility, that you are important. And the people that you eventually will go on to affect are important as well. For more information about iTHRIV and team science, please visit our website.